Hello, 6th standard students. Already in the last session, we have studied about the integers. Okay. Now, from this session, we are going to solve exercise. And today, we are going to solve exercise 6.1. So, without wasting our time, we will start to solve exercise 6.1. So, take your textbook, take your notebook, pen and pencil, and together we will solve exercise 6.1. Question number 1. Write opposites of the following. Increase in weight. So what is the opposite of increase? Decrease in weight. 30 km north and its opposite is 30 km south. You know the variable opposites. Increase, decrease. North, south. To 326 BC, that means before Christ, okay, and 326, that is AD. Loss of 700, profit of 700. 100 meter above sea level and its opposite is 100 meter below sea level. Is it easy? Question number 2. Represent the following numbers as integers with appropriate signs. An aeroplane is flying at a height 2000 meter above the ground, that means upside. So it will be the positive. So we will write positive 2000 meter. B. A submarine is moving at the depth 800 meter below the sea level. Below, that means downside. So we will write here, we will give here sign negative. Answer is negative 800 meter. A deposit of rupees 200. Deposit, that means plus 200. And withdrawal of rupees 700, that means we are taking out. So it is negative 700. Okay, because of technical problem, you will see here question mark, but we have to write rupees or RS or rupees sign. Okay. Question number 3. Represent the following numbers on a number line. Plus 5, that is positive 5 and negative 10. And the solution is, look at here. Okay, this is our number line and this is here 0. And on the same distance, we are going to draw here a vertical lines, which is numbering as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So at the right hand side, all are the positive numbers. And at the right left hand side, there are all negative numbers. And they told us to show us positive 5. So at the right hand side, we will show positive 5. As like that, here we can write A represents positive 5. And the negative 10, negative numbers are always left hand side of the 0. So at the left hand side, here B represents negative 10. So just remind that while drawing this number line, you have to take a proper distance between two vertical lines. And it should be same for all the lines. Okay. So draw properly. Question number 3. Represent the following numbers on number line, that is positive or negative 8. That means we have to show both negative 1, negative 6. So I am not going to give any explanation, that you have to find out first of all where are the positive and negative 8, negative 1 and negative 6. Afterwards I will tell you how we can represent. Okay, now the C1 is, we have to show positive and negative 8. So we will give C for the positive 8 and C dash. Okay, instead of C dash, you can give any alphabet also. So positive number is always at the right hand side and negative number is always at the left hand side. So as like that, we can here represent negative 1 with the help of D and negative C with the help of E. Question number 4. Adjacent figure is a vertical number line representing integers. observe it and locate the following points. Okay, now look at here, this is the number line and this is the zero. Okay, now we are going to give a numbers one by one. Okay, this is a zero. Now this is 2. Okay, why 2? Because we are going showing these numbers upside, that means all the positive number. So this is like this line indicates 1 and this line indicates 2. So as like this 3, this is 3 and this is 4. This is 5 and this is 6. This is 7 and this is positive 8. So it is not necessary to say always positive, but if you are going to represent the negative numbers, then you can always say that negative. So this one is negative 1 and this one is negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, negative 7, negative 8, negative 9, and E represents negative 10. So now which are the questions are there? If point D is positive 8, then which point is negative 8? Just look at here, which point is negative 8? Yes, absolutely correct. It is F. F represents negative 8. Is point G a negative integer or a positive integer? Look at here, where is the G? Yes, it is at the downside. That means it shows negative integer. Write integer for points B and E. Look at here, where is B? B indicates positive 4 and E indicates negative 10. Which point mark on this number line has the least value? Okay, which one is the least value? Negative numbers are always less than the positive numbers. So it is the least value is negative 10 because it is at the downside. Arrange all the points in decreasing order of the value. Decreasing order, that means from the highest to the lowest. So how we can represent D, C, B, A, O, O, H, G, F and E. Okay, is it easy? So question number 5, following the list of temperatures of 5 places in India on a particular day of the year. And the question is, place Siachen 10 degree below 0 degree Celsius, Shimla 2 degree Celsius below 0 degree Celsius, Ahmedabad 30 degree Celsius above 0 degree Celsius, Delhi 20 degree Celsius above 0 degree Celsius, and Srinagar 5 degree Celsius below 0 degree Celsius. So write the temperatures of these places in the form of integers in the blank column. So here, look at here, 10 degree Celsius below, that means negative 10, 2 degree below, that means negative 2, 30 degree above, that means positive 30, 20 degree above, that means positive 20, and 5 degree below, that means negative 5. Okay, so the second question is, following is the number line representing the temperature in a degree Celsius. Okay, so this is my line, and how we can show that? Look at here, we know that Siachen is negative 10, so on negative 10 here we wrote here Siachen. Shimla is negative 2, so between these two vertical lines of 0 and negative 5, here we draw some lines inner side. But how many lines that we have to draw? We have to count it. After 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and this bigger one vertical line is negative 5. So आपको count करके यहाँ पे vertical lines draw कर दी है. अगर आपको आपका मन चाहा है तो हमने 10 line draw कर लिया, तो ऐसा नहीं होगा. 0 और negative 5 के बीच में 4 ही lines आएंगी, 1, 2, 3 और 4 के लिए. So we will draw here only 4 vertical lines, and which will be the second? It will be shows Shimla for the negative 2 degree Celsius. Negative 5 degree Celsius is for the Srinagar, 20 degree Celsius is for Delhi, and Ahmedabad is for 30 degree Celsius. So as like this, these numbers are this number line representing the temperature in a degree Celsius. Okay, so which is the coolest place? Of course Siachen, because it is the with negative 10 degree temperature. Write the names of the places where temperatures are above 10 degree Celsius. Yes, it is Delhi and Ahmedabad, Delhi is 20 degree Celsius and Ahmedabad is 30 degree Celsius. So, question number 6, in each of the following pairs, which number is to the right of the other on the number? Okay, 2 and 9. Already we know that bigger number is always stands at the right hand side. So, 9 is to the right of 2 because 9 is a greater number. Negative 3 and negative 8. Between two negative numbers, which one is smaller is bigger, and that will be at the right side. So, negative 3 is to the right of the negative 8. देखिए जो भी negative number होंगे उनमें से जो छोटा होगा वही negative number बड़ा होगा. अगर वो बड़ा है तो वो right hand side पे होगा. बघा मुलांनो, जे negative numbers आहे त्यांच्यामध्ये जो स्मॉलर नंबर असेल, आता 3 आणि 8 मध्ये स्मॉलर नंबर 3 आहे, सो स्मॉलर नंबर जो निगेटिव मध्ये असेल तोच मोठा असतो. सो इट विल बी ॲट द राईट ऑफ द अदर नंबर. 0 अँड निगेटिव 1 ऑलवेज बिटवीन निगेटिव नंबर अँड 0. 0 इज द बिगर, सो 0 इज टू द राईट ऑफ द निगेटिव 1. निगेटिव 11 अँड 10 बिटवीन निगेटिव अँड पॉझिटिव, ऑलवेज पॉझिटिव आर द बिगर, सो 10 इज राईट ऑफ द निगेटिव 11. Negative 6 and 6, both numbers are same but signs are different and positive is always bigger. So, 6 is to the right of negative 6. 1 and negative 100, again positive number is to the right of negative number. So, 1 is to the right of negative 100. Question 7. Write all the integers between the given pairs. Write them in the increasing order. That means we have to write in an ascending order. Integers between 0 and negative 7. Ascending order लिखते वक्त हमें छोटे number से शुरुआत करनी होगी and we have to reach up to the bigger number. So, what will be the smaller number? It is negative 6. So, negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, negative 1. Between the negative numbers, the bigger one is always smaller. Integers between negative 4 to and 4 are, yes, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2 and 3. Integers between negative 8 and negative 15, now look at here, both are the negative numbers. So, which one is smaller? Yes, if we compare 8 and 15, 15 is a bigger, that means it is, but it is in a negative number, so it will be a smaller. Okay, so we have to start from the smaller numbers. So before negative 15, which number will come? Negative 14. So negative 14, negative 13, negative 12, negative 11, negative 10, negative 9. Integers between negative 30 and negative 23? Absolutely, we have to start from the negative 29. Negative 29, negative 28, negative 27, negative 26, negative 25, negative 24. Question number 8. Write 4 negative integers greater than the negative 20. Okay. Negative 20 is a smaller. Okay. And we have to write the bigger one. Okay. Now we are not going to consider negative sign 20. So, which one are the bigger? 21, 22, 23 and smaller 19, 18, 17. Okay. देखिए मैं फिर से कह रही हूँ और धीरे से बोलती हूँ. Bigger number than 20 are 21, 22, 23 and the smaller numbers than 20 are the 19, 18, 17. Okay. And if we are giving the negative signs to them, so what will happen? That 21, 22, 23 becomes smaller and 19, 18, 17 becomes bigger. So, what will be the answer? Here we have to write a greater number. So, we will write here negative 19, negative 18, negative 17 and negative 16. Write 4 negative integers less than negative 10. Yes, it is negative 11, negative 12, negative 13 and negative 14. Okay, you can see here is the negative sign. Because of this design, it is unable to see, but it is negative sign. So, it is negative 17 and negative 14. Question number 9. For the following statements, write true as a T and false or false F. If the statements are false, correct the statement. Negative 8 is to the right of the negative 10 on the number line. We know that at the right hand side there are the always bigger number. And between two negative integers, smaller is always bigger. So this statement is true. Negative 100 is to the right of negative 50 on a number line. And between two negative integers, which one is smaller is bigger. So this statement is false because negative 100 is to the left, because negative 100 is a smaller number as compared to negative 50. Smallest negative integer is negative 1. False. There is no smallest negative integers. There are infinite integers are there, so we cannot say that which one is the smallest negative integer and the biggest positive integer. Okay. Negative 26 is greater than negative 25. False, because negative 26 is smaller than negative 25. So which number will reach if we move 5 numbers to the left of 1? Look at here, this is the 1, okay? This is the 1, okay? And we have to move 5 numbers. So, now here we are taking 5 moves. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Which number will come here? Negative 4. So if we move 5 numbers to the left of 1, we will reach negative 4. Okay, listen here, this is a right hand side, because you can see, and this is a left hand side. Question number 10, draw a number line and answer the following. Which number will we reach if we move 4 numbers to the right of negative 2? Okay, so we move 4 numbers to the right, okay, of negative 2. Where is negative 2? This is negative 2 and this is right hand side and this is left hand side, and we have to move 4 moves. So 1, 2, 3 and 4, so plus 2. Okay, so if we move 4 numbers to the right of negative 2, we will reach 2. If we are at negative 8 on the number line, and in which direction we should we move to reach negative 13? So this is negative 8 and this is negative 13, so we have to move this side. So this is the left side. So, we will move to the left of negative 8 to reach negative 13. If we are at negative 6 on the number line, in which direction should we move to reach negative 1? Okay, this is negative 1 and this is 6. We are on the negative 6 and we have to, should move to reach negative 1. So, we have to move this side. So, this is right hand side, this is left hand side, and we are going here. That means we should move right to the negative 6 to reach negative 1. So, this is your homework that you have to solve exercise 6.1 in your notebook. Okay, watch this video again and again, listen this video again and again, listen the last session also, and try to solve exercise 6.1 in your notebook without taking any help of your parents and friends. And while solving, if you have any problem, you can call me anytime. Till then, have a good day.